today's video, we're going to be having a look at networks. A network is when two or more computers are joined together, and this allows them to communicate and share peripherals, such as printers. That means one printer can be purchased, but lots of users on the network could use that same printer. And this helps an organisation save money. There's three types of network that we're going to have a look at. There's a LAN, which is a local area network, a WAN, which is a wide area network, and a PAN, which is a personal area network. The LAN, or local area network, is over a small geographic area. This might be confined to one building or a school, and it allows all the users within that area to use the network. It's normally controlled by an organisation, and they'll be in charge of backing up the data and ensuring it's safe from cyber attacks. A WAN, or wide area network, is over a much larger geographic area. Now, this could be owned by a single organisation, such as an international bank, but more commonly, they're using lots of different networks to control one larger network. The internet is the largest one in the world, and that's not controlled by anyone in particular. A PAN is a personal area network, and this is a very small geographic area, for instance, between your phone and Bluetooth headphones or your smartwatch. So it's your own personal network, and it's normally used with Bluetooth or wireless. Now, a network may be managed in one of two ways. It might be a client-server network or a peer-to-peer network. Let's have a look at a client-server network first of all. A client-server network is one where there's a central server that controls all the clients or the devices on the network. This allows them to share printing, file management, things like that. And it's quite easy to back up and update the system from this one central server. A peer-to-peer network is slightly different. That's where all the computers on the network are equally important. So they all act like clients and they act like servers. And so they share the responsibility of running the network. Therefore, each computer is responsible for their own backups and their own updates, and they're also responsible for ensuring that they're safe from cyber attack.